Okay. September 9th, 9:52 AM, District Court Defendant's Lobby Number 1. Well, I guess this is it. Yep. One way or another, this case gets decided today. Ah, Phoenix, look!
Edgeworth.
Prosecutor Edgeworth. Hmm. I received a call from the Chief Prosecutor's Office yesterday. Hmm? I was told that whatever Mr. White says today will be the absolute truth, no matter how you try to attack his testimony. If I raise an objection, I have it on good faith that the judge will listen to me. What does White have in the judge in his pocket too? So you're saying I'm going to be guilty, end of story? I will do anything to get my verdict, Mr. Wright. Anything. Why? Why? How can you torment an innocent person like this? Innocent? How can we know that? The guilty will always lie to avoid being found out. There's no way to tell who's guilty and who's innocent. And that I can hope to do, all that I can hope to do is get every defendant declared guilty. Wow! You can actually prove innocence. You know that, right? Idiot. So, I make that my policy.
Edgeworth.
You've changed, man. You used to be cool. No, actually, you didn't. Hmm? Phoenix, you know him? Don't expect any special treatment, Phoenix Wright. Phoenix? Well, court will be starting soon. What? But wait! Your defense attorney isn't even here yet. They're not... I'll be defending myself. I am a lawyer. Seriously. What? Why are you so surprised by this? I'm a lawyer! Okay, let's do this. Honestly. You're gonna defend yourself? That's madness. That's right, I forgot all about the law when I was thrown in jail. Court is now in session for the trial of Mr. Phoenix Wright. Prosecution is ready, Your Honor. And the defense is ready, Your Honor. Mr. Wright, are you sure you're up to doing this? Kinda have to, don't I? Yes, Your Honor, I'll be defending myself. Understood. Very well, Mr. Edgeworth. Your opening statement, please. As the details of the event are already clear to the court, today we will hear the testimony of a witness to the defendant's crime. Oh. I see. The prosecution may call its witness. That went far too smoothly. Why didn't the judge ask Edgeworth why his witness didn't testify before? It's like he already knows why. Hmm. If anyone's going to raise an objection about this, I suppose it's me. Should we raise an objection now? I don't think it's going to work now, is it? Let me have a think about this for a second. So... let's let it go. I smell a trap. Because the judge would just, like, overrule the objection, right? There'll be a pre-formatted argument ready for it, and the judge has been told to accept everything he brings up. Would you like to call Mr. Red-White to the stand? Please state your full name. You wish to know the title of my personage? Oh, God. Mr. Bling. Your name? Yes, that's what I said. Oh dear, do my locutions confuse? Name? These two are great together. I wonder when the wedding is. My name is Red White. My friends call me Blanco Nino. Oh no. I am the CEO, or to use a more common term, the president of Blue Corp. Did you know the victim, Ms. Maya Fey? That would be a negatory, I did not. You were at the Gatewater Hotel the night of the murder? Correct. And you witnessed the murder from there? Why tell you what you already know? Very well, Mr. White, you may begin your testimony. If I can't rip this guy's testimony apart, I'm done for. Why do I always feel like it's the end of the world and I'm the last man standing? Oh ho ho! Bling! I hope you've made your peace with God, Mr. Lawyer. Let him have it, Phoenix. Alright, here we go. The witness account begins. It was about 9, I believe. Okay, that checks. I was quietly perusifying, that's reading to you, some paper by the window. Then I heard a bedlam coming from outside. Surprised, I turned to look at the building across the way. And then I saw him, a spiky-haired man attacking a woman with long hair. Needless to say, that man was none other than you, Mr. Lawyer. I called Miss May over at once. She too was flabbergasted, of course. The victim, she ran away, but you gave chase. Okay, he hasn't pre-prepared this one. Finally, there was a terrible impaction. There it was all over. If things occurred as you testified, I'm afraid the defendant is guilty. Very well, defendant. Mr. Wright. Your cross-examination? Yes, Your Honor. Okay. So we know it was about 9. Let's just review everything. This is different from April May's testimony. His testimony said, you know, she dodged the attack and then ran away. Her testimony says she ran to the right and was caught and struck. Either way, I mean, come on, this has to mean something with this vision cone, right? Where the body was in the middle of the vision cone, they can't see either side. That's got to come up at some point. Alright. So let's see, I believe it was about 9. Let's just press on everything. How do you know what time it was? Because I am always absolutely perfect, you know. No, you're not getting away with that. You are so mistrusting, Mr. Lawyer. So, what was the proper term for secrecy again? Anyway, Miss May ordered room service at 9. It happened soon after the room service arrived. That's what Miss May said too. Alright. No point pressing any further. Nothing to be gained. Okay, what were you doing at the time? I was quietly perusifying, that's reading to you, some papers by the window. By the window, you mean? The one directly across from Fay & Co. law offices? Correct. That's the only window you see. And there you were reading papers? Correct. The Gatewater is a businessman's hotel, and I am a busy man who had a lot of business to do. Then I heard a bedlam coming from outside. I'm just going to hold it on everything. A bedlam? It must have been when you attacked, I assume. We see. Continue. Surprised, I turned to look at the building across the way. Hold it! So you were reading your papers until you heard that sound. But of course, I am no snoop peeping out of the windows at night. No snoop, yeah, right. You've made a career out of snooping. A spiky-haired man attacking a woman with long hair. Spiky-haired? Needless to say, the man was none other than you, Mr. Lawyer. How can you be sure? Did you get a positive ID across the way? Actually, yes, it does. What you just said directly conflicts with Miss May's testimony. She stated the assailant looked like a girl. I've always been proud of my eyesight, Mr. Lawyer. And just what is your eyesight? counting both eyes, 40. Dude, are you for real? 40. You don't add them together. I think the witness is trying to say his eyesight is good.
Yeah.
Whose side is the judge on anyway?
We know that.
What did you do then? I called Miss May over at once. She too was surprised, of course. Now the bellboy said that she gave him a little peck on the cheek at 9. So how could she have been... What was Miss May doing at the time? Let's see if we can catch him out here. She had just finished watching a soap opera on the TV and was weeping openly. She wasn't getting room service? Did you know she'd been tapping the Fay office phone? Irrelevant. That has nothing to do with the case at hand. I cannot. I will answer the lawyer's bold inquiry. Miss May was acting alone when she tapped the phone of this Fay woman. You make a good politician, Mr. White. Oh ho, I know. After all, I am El Presidente. Please continue. The victim, she ran away, but you gave chase. Can you be a little more detailed about that? I think it's worth knowing what exactly happened. Of course. Comprende. I understand. The victim was attacked by you and ran to the left.
Ah, I got you now.
Really now? Ran to the left, you say? The only part of May's testimony that wasn't stricken from the record states the victim dodged an attack and ran to the right, not ran to the left. I'm pretty sure no matter how bad your vision is, versus hers and good and so on, left to right wouldn't get confused unless your eyes are in the wrong way around. And even then, that's not how they work, so... You gave chase and struck her down. Are you sure? Yes. You know, I'm always absolutely perfect. Can I present this yet? I can't. Perhaps you could change your testimony to reflect this new detail? Okay. So now we're going to do this. The victim ran to the left, you gave chase. So I called Miss May over. I was surprised, of course. The victim ran to the left and you gave chase. Right, now we can present this testimony as an objection. Wait right there. Mr. White, you've dug your own grave. What is this? You said the victim ran from the left, but that directly contradicts Miss May's testimony. She clearly stated the victim ran right. Oh. It's simple, you have misheard her. I think not. Look at the floor plans. The killer was here. The victim was here. If the victim ran to the left, as you claim she did, she would have been running directly away from the door. Ah, that makes no sense. Also, the direction that everything was knocked over has been knocked over from left to right, not right to left. She would have been running into a dead end. Don't you find that odd?
Oh?
Very strange. I did see her run to the left, I did. Phoenix, look at his face. I don't think he's lying about this one. Because he was there. True. Maybe he really did see the victim run left. Guys, he saw her run from right to left. Because, from this point of view, at the bottom, looking up, running to the left means heading towards the potted plants from the middle, right? But, flip it around, as if you were standing in the middle of the room, running to the left means running for the door. I got it. He said left because he did see her running to the left, but he saw it because he was in the room. Oh, what an idiot. So he did witness the killing, Wait a second. Here we go. Mr. Wright. Yes, Your Honor. Miss May says right, and Mr. White says left. Can you explain this contradiction to the court? Both are right. And I'm going to bedazzle you with how. Both witnesses are telling the truth for once. I doubt it. Rather, that does not clear up the contradiction. There is one scenario that would explain their conflicting account. What? Obviously, the witness was not viewing the crime from the hotel. Mr. Wright, what do you mean? Yes, what do you mean? He was not viewing the crime from the hotel. If he was not in the hotel, where could he have been? In the law offices of Fay & Co., of course. More specifically, he was standing here. Time to show the court where Mr. White was standing. Alright, well, he was standing there, wasn't he? Where the big red K is, the killer. This is where he was. Look. When the victim ran for the door, if he was watching from this point, to him, it would appear that she ran to the left. Please, this is no time for jokes in ill taste. This is where the killer was that is where the killer was standing. Yes, Edgeworth. You're slowly catching up to the argument. Well done. You just literally made the case for me, you idiot. Order, I will have order. Anyone disturbing the order of this courtroom will be held in contempt. Mr. Wright, what are you suggesting? A rapscallion? Objection! The postulations of the defense are a distortion of the truth, Your Honor. Indeed, they do seem a bit far-fetched. Oh ho ho! You provide us with so much entertainment, Mr. Lawyer. What now? He's laughing? The hilarity of the moment made me remember something. It appears I have been unclear, and for this I apologize. Mr. Your Honor, might I be allowed to testify once more? Very well, let's hear your revised testimony. Yeah, good luck, you can't fix a broken testimony, buddy. She ran to the left, okay. Miss May's testimony was correct, as was mine. When you assaulted the girl, she first ran to the left. Then you hit her savagely. That's what I saw. Next, with the last of her strength, she ran to the right. You chased her and delivered the final blow. That's what Miss May saw. You see? You hit her twice. Don't you remember, Mr. Lawyer? That does seem to make more sense. Will you be cross-examining the witness's testimony? You bet I will. I mean, yes, Your Honor. Hell yes. Okay. That says a blow, not multiple blows. The autopsy report doesn't say there were more than one hit. And that's the autopsy report that Edgeworth brought into the trial, the amended one. But still, this field of view thing, if she ran to the left, then to the right, he wouldn't have seen the second hit. The first hit. Oh no. Let's see where we go with this. When you assaulted the girl, first she ran to the left. Press. What do you mean, first? First, that's what comes before what happens next. Do you speak English, right? Please sit back and relax. I will try to use simple words for your benefits. First she ran to the left, then... And then you hit her savagely. That's what I saw. I didn't hit anyone. Now, Mr. Wright, there's no point in hiding things from the court. I'm not hiding anything. prosecution requests the defense refrain from interrupting the testimony. Mr. Wright, you have been warned. Oh, shit. Let's go this. Let's start from the beginning again. May's testimony was correct, as was mine. When you assaulted the girl, first she ran to the left, then you hit her savagely, that's what I saw. With the last of the strength, she ran to the right. Then you delivered the final blow. That's what Miss May saw. You hit her twice. Okay. What do you mean next? Next is what comes after first. Oh god, we're back to this. I know that. Then that's all you need to know, Mr. Lawyer. As I said, she turned and made a desperate dash to the right. You chased her and delivered a final blow. But we objected to the first blow. Pressed on the first blow. Pressing on the second blow didn't actually do anything either, I bet. That's what Miss May saw. So each of you saw different parts. Abso-positively. That's right, of course. Where did he pick up that annoying phrase? Anyway, moving along. You see, you hit her twice. So, I'm tempted to say it's the autopsy report is going to clear us on this. It says died from a blow. Mr. White. The victim died from a single blow.
Yeah,
that's right. What do you have to say to that? Now's my chance to hit him where it counts. Mr. White, wasn't it you who told this court you were abso-positively perfect? I will refrain from using this phrase from now on. Oh, thank God. Your Honor, if you would ask the witness for a new testimony... The witness is obviously confused, Your Honor. Which makes him a shit witness, don't you think, Edgewater? I would like to request a 10-minute break. Yes, quite. Objection. The witness is confused because he is lying. I emphatically request that there be no break, Your Honor. Oh god, the crowd are on my side. Hell yes! Very well. If the witness would care to revise his testimony. Crowd's on my side. No slipping out of this now, White. Mr. White? Oh, okay. So, testify as to the two accounts now. Well, see, I looked at the other window when I heard that thing fall. Then the next moment I saw Miss Mir run to the left. The killer, you, attacked, but she dodged. Suddenly she dodged now, instead of being hit. And then she turned and ran for the door. Then you did hit her with a single blow, thwap. Even the judge is like, what is this bullshit I'm hearing? Thwap indeed. Very well, you may begin with the cross-examination. Mr. Your Honor, my stomach, you see, it's hurting. You have a tummy ache. Deal with it. This is almost over.
You'll be in jail.
Okay, let's cross-examine. I looked at the other window when I heard the thing fall. What other window and what thing? You heard that thing fall? What exactly was that thing? Huh? Oh, that, the glass light stand. How the hell would you even see that? Again. This is where the field of view comes into account now, look. He wouldn't even see that. finally, I've been waiting for this to be relevant. Okay. Right, the one that had fallen over in the scene. Phoenix, doesn't something about that strike you as odd?
Yes.
Thank you. That is odd. I'll press further. Mr. White? Huh? What? You're saying you saw the glass light stand? Yes. Then change your testimony to reflect that, please. Sorry, my bad. The witness will revise his testimony again. Okay, of course. The light stand was lying on the floor when I looked. Okay. Then the next moment I saw her run to the left. Killer attacked her, but then she dodged. She turned and ran to the door. And then you whacked her with a single blow. Okay, none of that is something we're going to challenge. It's all about this light stand. Again. Now, I think I can present this as an objection. Mr. White, it was impossible for you to have seen the glass stand. What? Look at this. These are the floor plans to the scene of the murder, yes? Yes. Correct, Your Honor. Now, look. If you were to look through the window at the office, this is the area you would be able to see. Here. Finally. I've been waiting to use this forever. Well, note the stand is not within the visible area. Well, Mr. White, what do you have to say to that? Ridiculosity. Are you trying to cast like a charm against a boggart here or something? Mr. White, if you were in the Gatewater Hotel, as you claim, you could not have seen the stand before it fell over. In fact, you wouldn't have been able to see it after it fell either. There's no way you could have recognized the broken shards as a glass light stand. So, when did you see the stand, Mr. White? It must have been the moment that it fell. And the only place you could have seen that from is inside Fey Law offices. In other words, you were at the scene of the crime when the murder took place. Ah! Oh god. Wow, he went all rage mode then. Oh dear. Mr. White? Mr. White? You did it, didn't you? Mr. Your Honor, I... Miss Mia. Looks like we're about to get our verdict. Objection! That's far enough, Phoenix Wright. What? I forgot about Edgeworth. Mr. White, I think the time has come. Shouldn't you confess your crimes now, What? I said you should confess your crime. Ergo, confess that you placed the wiretap. God damn it, Edgeworth. This is your contingency. The wiretap. Order, order. Mr. Edgeworth, explain to the court what you mean by this. Distinguished members of the court, Mr. White is slightly confused. Allow me to explain. I don't like the way this is headed. As you know, Mr. White is the CEO of Blue Corp. He ordered his secretary, Miss April May, to tap the law offices of Miss Fay. What does that have to do, Your Honor? The question is, when was the wiretap placed in the office and by whom? No, you wouldn't. Mr. White, in order to place the wiretap, you entered the Fay offices, am I correct? Correct. You are most correct, Miles. Give me a break. Yes, in order to place the wiretap, I breached the Fay and Co. law offices. That's when I saw that accursed light stand. Now I'm confused. Please explain to the court what this means, Mr. Edgeworth. Yeah, this is kind of strange. What is he leaning at here? Like, He can't very well claim, oh, that's where he got that from, therefore he added it to his story because he's making it up. Because then he's making all of it up, including that he saw Phoenix Wright actually kill Mia. So this doesn't actually help. It just puts him, I mean, it gets him a much more reduced sentence, but still...